Given President Trump's historically low approval ratings, what specific steps are you and your colleagues taking to try to repair Trump's credibility?
So, Brian, I think that's the usual hyperbolic opening to one of the CNN segments. But let me tell you about the numbers that matter to Americans. The 1.5 million jobs created on his watch, the 54 record highs in the stock market closes, the consumer confidence level at a 17-year high, which means higher than both President George W. Bush and President Obama. Well, that is credibility. To the people who are paying attention, it is. Maybe not to CNN.
The American people are not giving him credit for the economic boom.
Yes, they are.
According to all of the polls.
Yes, they are. It depends on how you ask the question. I mean, you have the voice going through all of your promos saying, CNN, the most trusted name in news. What evidence do you have of that? I've seen polling numbers to the contrary on that.
You're talking about CNN instead of President Trump.
No, I'm happy to talk about President Trump. You interrupted me because I was going through what CNN refuses to cover about President Trump, which is the economic boon on his watch as president.
The fact economy that is covered every day, Kellyanne.
That's not true. But you just want to argue about it because you don't like, you say facts first, so I'm giving you the facts about the stock market, the 1.5
I appreciate that, but what
created.
I asked is about President
really
Trump's credibility
it?
And how the White House is repairing this credibility crisis. Do you have an
That's
answer
what you
to
call
that
it.
Question?
Yeah, here's the deal. The credibility crisis exists on the other in the other party now. I just cannot believe the bombshell that Donna Brazile has launched, where she says that she was dealing with three, quote, Titanic egos, President Obama,
you know,
Hillary
I stopped
Clinton,
taking Donna Brazile seriously when she lied
Why?
And when it was revealed that CNN fired her for giving debate questions to Hillary
wow.
Clinton.
That's
I'm not here to ask you about
I think
Donna
that's
Brazile.
Very, excuse me, I think that's very unkind to Donna Brazile. She saw what we saw out there, which is a lack of enthusiasm for Hillary Clinton. She was worried, rightfully so, that the polls were wrong, including CNN's polling. I know you fired your
I'm here, with all due respect, Kellyanne, to ask you about
if you want to
President
talk about
Trump,
credibility, let's
not
talk
Hillary
about it.
Clinton.
I talk,
do your
I
internal polls
about,
also show him with historically low approval ratings?
You don't. So you want to talk about approval ratings, and I'm telling you about the numbers that matter to Americans. Look,
because his approval ratings are shockingly low. It's a problem, not just for you and for me, but for the nation, that this president is not trusted by the American people.
No, that's wrong. You know what's a problem for
How
this
is that
nation?
Wrong?
That you refuse. CNN used to be a place where people can tune in and get the news all day long. Now they get spin in people's opinions. And I think CNN should own it. Brian, why not just say, look, it's in our commercial interest at CNN to be anti-Trump. We're profitable if we're against the president. Most of our viewers are against the president. Just own it. Don't you think that would be more credible for CNN than pretending that you're straight
down the
middle?
I understand that you don't want an adversarial media. You just want everybody to be like Fox News.
Media.
State-run
no, that's
media?
Not true. Stop being so jealous of Fox News, Brian, and their ratings. I think that would help if you drop the jealousy a little bit about Fox News. The fact is
Let's put on
that
screen.
we need a media that covers the facts. The fact is, if consumer confidence is at a 17-year high, that's relevant to the forgotten man or forgotten woman.
I agree, but Kellyanne, this is like a doctor walking in and saying... It's like a doctor walks in and says, you have cancer and it's spreading throughout your body. But the good news is your legs still work and your feet still work. It's great that I can walk, but I want to treat the cancer, Kellyanne. And that's why I'm asking you about his historically low approval ratings.
Well, I'm not going to buy into that awful analogy because I know many people suffering with terminal cancer right now. So I think it's a terrible analogy you just offered to the viewers. I want to tell you something about the president. He's on a historic trip to Asia. The country is watching that. They're listening to him directly and they get the news directly from him. I know there's a lot of hand-wringing in the mainstream media that the country doesn't need you anymore to spin and filter what the president just said. They read his tweets when you read his tweets. It's a democratization of information. They don't need you to tell, they don't need you to tell them what the president just said. He's given a lot of press availability. Every time he's taking off from the South Lawn now, practically, he's talking to the press. I've been in the room several times last week when the president is answering questions to a live pool spray that have nothing to do with why they were there, like the cabinet meeting, the Ways and Means meeting the other day. There are many different actions by this president where he is very full and forthcoming, and he's answering these questions. I don't think that you can find a more transparent, more forthcoming president in recent times that is engaging with the media and usually spontaneously. I mean, isn't that refreshing?
I think it's laudable that he's been taking questions from the press, but I did think it was troubling when he said on Friday to the press corps that he's disappointed in the Justice Department. You're reasonable. You know it's disturbing to have a president trying to meddle in the Department of Justice. Have
but
you counseled
not.
Him to stop doing that?
So, Brian, go back and look at the president's full quote. He said, I want the Justice Department to run itself. He said, I like it to run itself. He said that. That means he is not interfering and meddling. But he has expressed consternation and the occasional frustration publicly for a very long time about the fact that the Department of Justice and the FBI don't seem interested in both sides of the so-called collusion coin. And
so even is he going CNN, to replace Jeff Sessions?
No, that's not what he's saying. That is not what
he's saying.
He'd
be disappointed if he wants them to do it differently.
Well, first of all, you want me to go on tape saying he will never replace X or so-and-so will be here all 8 years. I'm not going to do that because that's silly. You guys always want to know who's up and who's down, and the American people care that the stock market is up and unemployment is down. But to this point, we've got multiple investigations through Mr. Mueller, through congressional and Senate committees, and CNN itself has been so hot on Russia, 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 on the dossier. CNN's been obsessed with this dossier for over a year now. And now that we know the DNC and the Clinton campaign paid the same firm for said dossier, which is completely unverified, we can't get you excited. If you look back at your whole year,
that is misinformation that you're spreading on my program, Kellyanne.
Hold on, a lot of it has not been verified.
Much of the dossier.
Hold on.
You just said the entire dossier is unverified.
No,
that is inaccurate.
It has not been verified. It has not been verified.
But the pieces of the dossier have been verified.
And
when you say
Brian,
it's unverified, you actually mislead the American people.
No.
Carter
Don't
Page actually
that.
Confirmed another part of the dossier on Friday.
Don't start with that. You know that entire dossier has not been verified, and yet the interest in
parts
covering
of it have not been verified. Parts
are you comfortable
have been
with
verified.
That? Are you comfortable
I
with
am
that?
Comfortable
By the way, we don't even care about the dossier here because
investigation
let me,
into what's
let me tell
true
you
what's
something.
False.
Yeah. Great. Then let's look at all sides of the coin. Tell me this. Why, if President Obama and apparently, according to Donna Brazile now, Attorney General Holder, National Security Advisor Susan Rice, they all knew about, they were all told about possible Russian meddling. Why didn't they tell us at the campaign? They knew last summer. We weren't told.
There were warnings. I agree. There should have been more. You're right about
absolutely
that. There should have been
okay,
better,
so should that be part of the investigation?
Warning.
So if we're going to look forward to our democracy, our unimpeded, uninterfered democracy, Brian, which I know you and I both agree with, then why wouldn't we look at that? Why weren't we warned?
I don't know what Mueller's looking
at. Is it because everybody thought Hillary Clinton was going to win and it wouldn't matter? But I want to say something else. As the campaign manager for the winning part of the campaign,
yeah,
I never a single time even thought about what to do, how to deal with Russians to win. Hillary Clinton, as Donna Brazile just pointed out, I agree with her completely. She was a walking, talking treasure trove of how to beat Hillary Clinton. We never needed to look farther than her. And as Donna points out, there was this feeling of inevitability and smugness over in Brooklyn that they didn't have to campaign on the issues, that they didn't have to campaign hard. She didn't see the enthusiasm for Hillary Clinton,
sure,
neither did we.
Viewers,
so there'd be no reason to talk to
pivot.
Moscow.
I think viewers see what you're doing, pivoting. When I say Russia,
no,
you say Clinton. It's part
oh,
of a
no,
strategy.
No.
Would
sorry.
You agree?
If you want to talk about, listen, I'd be happy to never talk about the 2016 election again. You know why?
I don't know
we
about
won it.
That.
We won it. I broke
well,
the glass ceiling.
Well, let's agree not to talk about it during this
interview.
And I work
here. This guy is governing. Hold on. But the
sure
reason that we're still talking about it is because of the DNC, because Hillary Clinton's on a book tour that you're not considering you're considering nonfiction, not fiction. They're still talking about the 2016
just
campaign.
Jab,
it turns
jab,
out they were
jab
trying
you
to
just love to beat
well,
on Hillary Clinton. It's
we're
boring.
Here. No.
It's outdated.
She
it's
is
history.
Incredibly boring.
Let's talk
Hold
about
on.
What's happening in the building behind
Hold on.
You.
It's it. Right.
I need
well,
to ask you about the Justice Department
let's do that.
Because
Tax
you're
cuts.
Saying that the president's not
Asia
interfering
trip.
In the Justice Department. There are serious concerns that he is. For example, you know the biggest
At
pending
CNN.
Media merger is the AT&T Time Warner deal. Time Warner owns CNN. This week, there was a sense the deal was about to be approved until this headline came out in the Wall Street Journal. It says the Department of Justice is weighing a lawsuit to block the AT&T deal. Has President Trump had any involvement in the review of this deal, Kellyanne?
Brian, you know better than to go ahead and throw all that poison out to your viewers, which you know
That's
are heavily Democratic and anti-Trump because it's a business model you should own. But at the same time, the Department of Justice and the different departments within the Department of Justice who look at merger deals will mm-hmm. do their work. We're not going to interfere with that here. And
so
I
President
can understand
Trump's
why
not had any
I can understand why some of your
deal.
Colleagues are nervous about another merger. I get that. But I'm not I really don't want to spend the White House's time and our platform today on CNN with you, Brian, talking about something that affects you and your employees. Let the Department of Justice, a very large place, let them do their job here. Let Mr. Mueller do his job.
Independently? I agree. They should
well,
be independent.
Of course. Well, of course, the Department of Justice is independent.
But when the president's complaining every day about the Justice Department, people cannot trust that he's leaving
he
the department alone. You see what I
no,
mean?
No, that's not true.
He's complained several
no,
days
no, no.
in a row. It was
no, no, no. He's a Yeah, but he also said, play the full clip if you want to be honest and completely forthright about it. Facts first, Brian. Show the whole clip of the president saying, I want the Department of Justice to run itself. That's non-interference. Okay?
President Trump said before Election Day that he vowed to block the AT&T deal. That's why this is significant. Does he still oppose the AT&T deal?
I haven't discussed that with him lately because it's not important to what we're doing here, which is he just went on a historic Asia. He's at the beginning of a historic Asia trip.
Cutting taxes. But these deals are important. He's been bashing the Justice Department. What about the Sinclair Tribune deal? Sinclair has a conservative bent. Does he oppose that deal?
Haven't discussed that with him recently. We don't discuss that here. Those are deals in the private sector that the Department of Justice will or will not look at. That's up to them.
But it's so opaque. That's the issue, Kellyanne, is I'm looking for more transparency. I'm looking for more transparency on a variety of topics.
No,
I think that's how the president could regain his credibility.
That don't take place. No, that's not true.
I think the president can regain his credibility by being more transparent. On his tax returns, for example, the deadline for him to file his federal tax return was October 18th. Do you know if he has filed his federal tax return?
You know what his tax return might look like in the future? A postcard or a point.
That's a great pivot, and I respect the pivot. But why will he not release this year's tax return?
I think Americans want to know about the tax cuts. You know they want to know about the tax cuts. You know that that affects them. They're waiting to get middle-class tax relief. They're waiting for trillions of dollars that are parked overseas legally to come back. They want those jobs back here. It's how he won, and he's making good on all that. You don't want to cover that. You want this whole year to basically be... I mean, if CNN looked back upon this whole year, you should be dispatching from the Kremlin, not Capitol Hill. You've been obsessed with one major issue, 54 stock market highs, and all 54 days, you've covered Russia. I mean, is that responsible?
If you'd like to join CNN as a producer, I'm sure we can find an opening if you'd like to be involved in editorial decisions.
I had a nice offer from CNN, but I came inside instead, and I respect CNN. Look, CNN plucked me out of the wilderness 20 years ago when I knew nothing about going on TV. I'll always be grateful for that, but I don't understand.
But I asked about tax returns. I asked about why the president won't release his tax return, and you're talking about CNN instead.
He's answered that many times. You're still talking about the 2016 election. You sound like Hillary Clinton.
No, I'm asking about 2 weeks ago was the deadline for him to return his federal tax return. I think it's kind of embarrassing the press didn't ask more about this last month. The deadline was October 18th,
and
yet we haven't seen his tax return yet.
CNN is in the front row at the press briefings every day. They choose what to ask. They've been out there on the South Lawn every single time.
Sure, I'm glad
your colleagues are shouting questions during press pools. I'm right there to listen to
you, and the president is answering those
questions.
That's the value of it. Let me ask you one more about transparency. President Obama underwent physicals in 2010, 2011, 2014, 2016. Will President Trump see the White House doctor, and will he release the results of his physicals?
I don't ask the president about private matters, about his health or
his interactions. All presidents disclose their medical records, and they disclose their physicals when they're in the White House. It's not a private matter.
I am not going to comment on that today. I will just say that as President Obama was doing that, he was lying to the American people about keeping their doctor in their plan. Again, that's what animates Americans, that 28 million Americans still don't have health care.
I'm against liars. Obviously, I'm against liars. But President Trump has a track record of misinformation.
Don't
I didn't call him
a liar.
Brian. I said I'm against liars. Against liars. But President Trump has a track record of misinforming the public. Do you advise him as counselor to the president not to spread misinformation?
The president communicates directly with the people all day long through his Twitter feed, through his availability to the press. Hold on. That is not true, Brian. Hold on. And that you
He said Broadcom was a Fortune 100 company this week. It's not even a Fortune 500 company.
And you know what people will be happy? They'll be happy that Broadcom came here to the White House and announced that it will be creating jobs in this country. Go ask the people. You don't get out there and talk to the people like we do, respectfully. Hillary Clinton didn't respectfully. I didn't see you or her in Wisconsin. But the fact is this.
Kellyanne, my family's from Wisconsin. I love Wisconsin.
Good.
I'd love to go to you to Wisconsin.
Right. Let's do it.
You can't sit here and say, Brian, you don't go and talk to the people.
No.
That's
just
insulting.
You didn't last year. You guys were doing national polls. You missed the whole zeitgeist. My point to you is go and talk to whoever gets the jobs from Foxconn in Wisconsin or from Broadcom elsewhere and ask them what they care about. Ask them what their tax returns are going to look like. Ask them if they care if Broadcom is a fortune this or a fortune that. They're going to be happy that they have a job, and you are not connecting that. I think a lack of transparency is also not telling the American people all the good that's happening for them. If people just want to hear the negative, 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 they'll continue to tune in. But not everybody's tuning in, Brian. Your ratings are not as high as other networks, cable stations, because people
need to go
somewhere else.
Then why are you here, Kellyanne? You're going to take a shot at me. Why are you here?
No. Excuse me.
Clearly, you want to influence.
At my boss. I know I'm more than happy. Listen, I'm always happy. And you've got people probably on Twitter now. You'll read it. I'll go home and watch the Philadelphia Eagles become 8-1 and take my kids to something fun today. But you will go on Twitter the rest of the day as you're holding your precious baby daughter, and you will see what people said, and you will realize how anti-Trump the CNN viewers are now. So go ahead and give them something different to look at.
What they're going to say is, Brian, you shouldn't have had that woman on CNN. You shouldn't
have her on. They say it all the time. They don't realize how often we're invited to be on CNN. That's right.
That's right. I ask you.
They have no idea how often we're invited.
I try to book you every week.
I didn't know that, but I'm happy to come on more frequently. I will tell you that right here and right now. But look, can't we just make a deal of some sort that we can actually get more? If you want facts first, there are facts out there that you're not telling the American people. And I just think cherry picking. Well, look, you're a 24/7 cable. You're a 24/7 news outlet. You have a lot of people on your digital platform. You have international audiences. Don't you want them to hear that the stock market is an all-time high? Don't you want them to hear that? But it's just in passing. It's never quite. Look, Sarah's briefings, most of what everybody covers is the Q&A. The rich part of those briefings is at the beginning when she is outlining the facts of what just happened that day.
She read a conservative chain email from the podium. It was embarrassing.
The national security. I don't know what you're talking about there, but I'm saying
she read a chain email about tax returns the other day. Remember on Monday?
She is listing out, and I do find it curious. I think people should take note of what you're not asking me today. You're not asking me a thing about, as the winning campaign manager, you're not asking me a thing about Russia, about what we were doing. You know, the day, you want to talk about CNN polling? The day that I got there as campaign manager, we were down double digits according to CNN polling. And even if your polling was off a few points, we know we were losing. And the fact is, I never once considered not looking at Michigan and looking at Moscow instead. I don't know what other people were doing earlier in the campaign, but I can tell you, just as the indictments last week, these indictments last week had nothing to do with the campaign, had nothing to do with Russian collusion.
But you've brought us back to the election again.
Because that's what CNN is covering. I didn't even mention her name. I would be happy to never talk about her again, but she won't go away. No. You're talking about Russia collusion, which has to do with the campaign. You're not talking about it here as we're governing, right? That all has to do with the campaign, correct?
The way that Russia attacked us last year is the biggest story
I can
think of.
Now you're talking about the campaign.
Russia continues to attack us today. They're going to attack us in the midterms, Kellyanne, and I don't see your boss doing enough to protect us.
Wait, excuse me. We have a lot going on with respect to cybersecurity in this administration. Every single day, something's being done in that space. But hold on. Okay. You can't have it both ways, Brian. You can't, and your network, constantly talk about Russia, 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 which has everything to do with the 2016 campaign. And then the minute I touch the soft underbelly of this nonsense, you accuse me of wanting to talk about the campaign. I work here. Hillary Clinton doesn't. And this man is governing. He's doing things for the American people. He's trying to get those 28 million Americans who are left in the cold without health care reform. He's trying to get a middle-class tax cut. He wants to reduce the corporate tax rate to 20%.
That's why his approval ratings are stuck in the mud. What are you going to do about the approval ratings?
Listen, his approval ratings don't matter as much as all the numbers. And I say this when they're up, and I've said this when they're down. I've been around a very long time. I'm an old woman, Brian. I've talked about approval ratings on this network and others for decades, and they're not as important as what matters. If consumers feel confident and they're out there spending their money, if job creators feel like they can attract and retain the American workforce, bring that wealth and bring those jobs home. If corporate America, I've never seen Washington so organized.
The only thing we disagree on is that the press doesn't cover it. I'm sitting right by the CNN Money newsroom. Dozens of reporters cover the economy every day.
That's great. On your shows. But I know you hear what I'm saying, and it's the chyrons. But, you know, I'm just telling you, just own it. Just own it, as CNN. You're a very prominent person there. Just say, you know, we're doing better in the ratings. We're getting better ad revenues because we're one of the more anti-Trump than down the line outlets. Just own it. I think it's okay to do
that.
We're not
anti-Trump, Kellyanne. We're pro
truth. Your panels are six versus one,
and
you know that.
We're pro decency. And this is a tough moment in American history for people that support facts and decency.
Excuse me. We've had many tough times in American history.
Sure.
But you know, Benghazi didn't happen because of a tape. You all covered that. People couldn't keep their doctor and couldn't keep their plan.
I hear Clinton. Let's talk next time.
You want to talk about facts, but the fact is, Brian, I appreciate being on. We appreciate the platform.
Thank you.
And I'm always willing to do that when I'm available. Thank you.
Hey, we're both rooting for the Eagles today, at least. That's what we
have
in common.
8-1 coming up.
All right. See you soon. Thank you for being here.
Take care.